We begin now at the top of Daf Tes Amud Aleph from Maseches Shabbos. This is Shabbos Daf 9a. The Gemara just finished quoting a brisa, which is a question on Rava. Rava said that from the Malkum Patur to the Rishus Rabban, let's say, or vice versa, that he would not be chayiv in such a case. So the Gemara is now finishing that question. Derech Olav Chayiv, Rashi explains. Derech Olav Shigbiu Lamalamiyud. This was Rava's statement. A person carries the thing above 10 tefachim. The Lo Shalit Be Avi Rishus Rabban for having Malkum Patur. It's in a Malkum Patur Chayiv. Ki Hadar An Chayiz Chayiv. Even though he went through a makom patur. So the question is, which one is it? If a person carries something through a makom patur, but it starts off in a makom chiyuv and it ends in a makom chiyuv, is he chayiv or not? So the Gemara answers, hasam lo nach hachanach. Over there, in the case of Rav, it never came to rest in the makom patur. He carried something four amos in Rishus Rav, he lifted it up for a time that it was above the airspace of Rishus Rav, it was above 10 tefachim, but it never came to rest in the makom patur. So it never essentially stopped moving. When it comes to the case of the Braisa, it actually rested in the Malkum Patur, so it was like two separate carryings, one from the Rishus Hayachid to the Malkum Patur, one from the Malkum Patur to the Rishus Harabim, and therefore the Malkum Patur breaks it up, and the person is Patur, and that's the answer to the contradiction. Gemara now continues at the two dots again, according to the Braisa, Acherim Omrim, others say, Iskopa Mishameshes Shtei Rishuyos, that when it comes to a threshold, we'll see what kind of threshold as we continue, but it counts as it could either be Rishus Hayachid or Rishus Harabim. Bizman Sha Pesach Pasuach Kilifnim, when the door is open, it is as if you are inside, it is a Rishus Hayachid. So that would be, let's say, the door of the house or the Mavui, we'll see in a moment. Pesach Nol Kilachutz. But if the door is closed, then the threshold, it's essentially closed off from the Rishus Hayachid, so the threshold has a status of Rishus Harabim. So that's a quote from the Braisa. Now the Gemara asks, V'yafa gav de lesle lechi? Is this true even though there is no lechi? A lechi is a post that is at the usually at the entrance of a mavo. Even though there's no lechi at the entrance of this threshold, V'yomer avcham bar gurya amarav tocha pesach tzarech lechi acher latiro, that within a doorway containing a threshold, you need to have a second lechi in order to matir. We do not say that the lechi is considered mutter automatically, that the threshold is mutter automatically as Rishus Hayachid without a lechi. Let's see Rashi here to understand this. Rashi explains, Pesach Basuach v'chulu. Kasal gadaitach b'mavui shechshiru b'lechi. Right now the Gemara understands here, we're talking about a mavui, it's an alley. And the way an alley works is you have in this alley various people. It's all the Rishus Hayachid, but it's different Rishuyos Hayachid. It's different individuals living within this alley. There's different chatzeros in the alley, and then within each chatzer there's different houses. So it's an alley that's shared by a bunch of people. So the halacha generally is you are allowed to carry the mavui if you put a lechi, a little post, a wooden post, at the entrance of the alley. V'lechi of lefnim min ha'eskopa, and in this case, the lechi that we're talking about is on the inside of the threshold. V'hayon dekavatama v'yaf agav delesle lechi mibachutz. Don't you need a lechi to be on the outside of the threshold? V'amar avchama tocha pesach shel mavoi dehainu rochav eskopa. In other words, when you enter the alley, so there's two walls, a wall on either side of you, that is the pesach, that's the doorway, that's the threshold. That area, tzarech lechi acher la'atiro, shal lechi hamater es ha'mavoi, sasme neged eskopa. The way it works is that the lechi is right up flush against the entrance of the mavui, towards the inside of the mavui. So anything outside the lechi, anything before you cross that threshold into the mavui, you can't carry. You're only allowed to carry from the inside edge of the lechi and inward. It's like a wall. So imagine picturing you're exiting the mavui, you'd actually see this lechi and it would appear like a wall. That part that you can see as you enter, that's the borderline. That's where you're allowed to carry from. And outside of that area, you can't carry. V'lefnim havi heker mechitza, only towards the inside is there a heker mechitza, is it nicker that this is a wall. So how could you carry on the threshold even if the door is open? In other words, even if this mavui has no closed door, you don't have a lechi here to allow you to carry, and you do need a lechi and a mavui to carry. So that's the question of the Gemara. The Gemara then suggests an answer. V'chi teimah deles bei dalet al dalet. Maybe you'll answer that the thickness of this threshold is less than 4x4 tvachim, and therefore you don't need another lechi. V'yomer rav chama bar gur yomer rav tocha pesach afa v'she'in bo dalet al dalet tzarech lechi achar latir. It's not true. Rav chama bar gur says in the name of Rav, even if it's not dalet al dalet, you still need another lechi. So that's not going to be a good answer. right, it's good to take a look at all these Rashi's here. Rashi says, V'chitem in the Les Bay Rach of Dalet, B'meshech Ove Achoma, within the thickness of the wall, there's no Dalet al Dalet. L'fika chen Rishos La'atzma, it's not its own Rishos. U'mutr l'shtamish, can I get Alachim Echudu Achitzon, Shushava, L'iskopa, Eitzel Rishos Aravim. So maybe you'll say, this is not going to be true, but maybe you'll say, since it's not 4x4, it's not its own Rishos, and suddenly you're going to be allowed to carry even from the outer edge of the lechi. You don't need another lechi. The ain lechol lechi gadol meove achomash amikan amikan shemem amavinitter. You don't have a lechi that is bigger. There's no such thing as a lechi that's bigger than the thickness of the wall. So basically, in other words, the point is that maybe if it's less than dalet al dalet, you won't need a second lechi to matir between between the walls, essentially within the threshold. The Gemara says no, you do. So what's the answer to this question? How is it that on this threshold it counts as a Rishus HaYachid when the door is open? So Amar Rav Yudah Marav, Rav Yudah says in the name of Rav, Hacha Biskopis Mavoy Askin. Here we are talking about a threshold of a Mavoy. Chetzio Mekorah v'chetzio She'enu Mekorah. It's not talking about a case of a Lechi at all. We're talking about where you have, instead of Korah, a beam on the top. Half of it has a beam over it. The other half of this threshold does not. The beam is on the inside of the threshold. V'kiruv klaplei pnim. That's the next line. The beam is on the inside of the threshold. Pesach pasuach kelefnim. So in such a case, if the door is open, you can count it all like the inside. Pesach nol kelechutz. But if the door is closed, if the door is open, you count it like it's a Rishus HaYachid. If the door is closed, then it counts like a Rishus Rab. We should take a look at Rashi here as well. Rashi says, Hacha biskopis mavoy askinon kedoka amrin, as we've been saying. It's an interesting Rashi already, because the Gemara sounds like we haven't been talking about a mavoy until now, and Rashi's opinion has been, this entire discussion, the last few lines, has been about a mavoy. So that's why Rashi puts in the word kedoka amrin. As we have been saying the entire time, we're talking about a mavoy right now. We're not talking about a mavi with a lechi that's making it mutter. We're talking about a mavi with a kora. The kora is a mavi shirach v'tefach. How big is the kora? It's the tefach. Parakam and Erevin. We learned that in the first parak of Erevin. Says Rashi, the thickness of the doorway, the thickness of the threshold is wide. Half has this beam over it, half doesn't. And of course, the Korah is, as we said, towards the inside of the Mavi. Hilkach. Pesach pasuach kelefnim, mechud hachitzon shel Korah vilefnim. This is the key. If the door is open, then everything from the outer edge of the Korah inside, you can count it as Rishus HaYachid. Mesavar lo kamadam or mudr l'shtamish tachas ha-Korah, omishon tam de akeira milavar, kem afarsh pil kzayim erivin, omishon dekor mishon mechitza, damin chud hachitzon yorim isosim. Different mechanisms, how it works, that you can use this Korah from the outer edge of the Korah, but whatever the case is, you can use the outer edge of the Korah. Either it's because it's a hecker, it's recognizable from there, or because we apply a rule that the edge of this Korah goes down as if it is a wall. Fine. Pesach no, if the door is closed, v'hadelis shokef b'fneo eskopa apnimis, the door now is kind of closing on the inner part of the threshold, so the threshold's excluded from the mavoi when the door is closed. V'chol ho eskopa chutz l'delis kilachutz. So then, in that case, if the scope is outside the door, kilachutz, v'afilo tachas hakorah, even under the korah is going to be kilachutz. The kevan the nistam ha-mavoi batla lo korah. Halach is, once the mavoi is closed, once you close that door, the korah loses its shame korah. It's no longer a korah. V'lekel mimer yorid v'sosim, you can no longer say the rule of yorid v'sosim. It cannot come down as an imaginary halachic wall. The chol mechitza she'en bein chalal ha-mechitza's dalid, einon mechitza's v'lo shaycha b'toras good achis. There's no good achis in such a case if the mechitza doesn't have within the korah is only one tefach thick. It's not going to be 4x4, so you can't do good achis. Lahachi lo'ukma, says Rashi here, important going on to the next thing. Lahachi lo'ukma b'skop is bias. Why are we saying here it's got to be with a mavui? We stress this whole situation has to be with a mavui. To stand by is Pesach shalo yesh lo mashkof milamala. He says, because the house, the way it's usually structured, there is above a roof the whole way. V'nimtza ove ha-pesach klum makorah. It's usually the doorway of a house. You're going to have over the thickness of the wall on top of you. It's going to be totally roofed, totally with a korah. V'afilo pesach nola min yor v'sosim, shere yesh b'chalal ov yav dal min adelas, l'stimas p'yatikor. In such a case, just a standard scenario, even if the door is closed, it's going to be 4x4 there. There's going to be a thick four tzvachim ceiling over you, and you can say a rule that it creates a halachic wall. But if it wouldn't have been for v'hu adin d'matzi l'mon kula makora el shein baruch avav yivdalet, you could have always said that the whole thing has a kora, and it happens to be it's not for. Elamishem d'stam ove achome eno pachas midalet. Generally, when you walk into a mava, you walk into a house, you're going to have a thickness of four. So what we wanted to do is we wanted to make it a case of a mavoi and have a normal kora in a mavoi, which a kora of the mava is only a tefach wide, so you can't apply these halachic rules creating it and turning it into a wall if the door is closed. If the door is open, of course, then it has the status, halachic status of a korah, and you can carry under the korah. So that's the first answer over here. The Gemara then says, Rav Ashi Yom, Rav Ashi says, Leolam biskopes bayas haskin. And really, we are talking about a house. Ukagon shakira b'shtei koros. There's two koros, two beams on the top of this threshold that are acting as a roof. She'ein bazu arba vein bazu arba. Neither one has four tvachim. V'ein bein zu lazu shlosha. However, there's less than three tvachim between them. So we apply a rule called lovud, and we bind them together as if they're one large beam, one large roof. That's 4x4. And then videl. So then theoretically, you can create here a halachic mechitza and carry. Videl is b'emtza. However, the door, when it closes, it actually separates the two beams. It's right in the middle of the two beams, so you would no longer be able to use lavud. So pesach pasuach kilafnim. If the door is open, you can bind together halachically the two beams, and you create a halachic mechitza you can carry under there. It's like rishus hayachid. Pesach noal kilachutz. However, if the door is closed, the door actually rests between the two beams, and it creates that you can no longer have this halachic wall. Rashi explains. Biskopes bayis shakula pesach mekor. The whole thing has a roof. V'hayin otam et pesach anol kolachutz kegon shakira ovye ha-pesach b'shtei koros. The case is the thickness of the doorway has two beams. De'ilu tikra sheyesh ba'dalid amin and b'yorid v'sosim. Again, like we said before, if it would be four tvachim wide, we would apply the halachic rule of yorid v'sosim, it would be a mechitza. V'su lo asin inglas delos umavat l'mechitza. Even closing the door wouldn't stop it. V'afilu shokef v'em tziyasu de lo damu l'mavoy de koras mavoy ketzari. When it comes to the kor of a mavoy, the kor of a mavoy is very thin. V'lo hoch shal the mavoi, it's only for the mavoi itself. Hikach pesach nol batla mitoras korah. Therefore, when the door closes, it's no longer has a din of a korah. To ha'azalei mavoi, there's no din of a mavoi. It's the mavoi's gone. You close the door. Aval tikras dalid, but if it's four, lo batla yiridas timas benilas delas, the closing of the door isn't mevatel the halachic wall. The halachal moshe mesinai who good v'loved v'dofen akuma. These are different halachal moshe mesinais. But makam dal, they only apply when they're when it's four tefachim thick. V'hacha time mishum d'shtei korahs havish ein bazu arbav. But here's a special scenario. You have two beams up on top. Neither one is big enough, but they are close enough together to halachically connect. But the door is right there in the middle. Therefore, if the door is open, it's like Rishus HaYachid. Since there's less than three tvachim between the two beams, we apply the halachic principle of love it and join them together. It's like one large beam. The outer edge of this beam halachically comes down as a wall. It's now four. However, Pesach Nol Kelachutz, Kevin Dev Emso, Nimso Mafsik by name, it's in the middle, it's a Hefsik, or Mechalkan Zumizu, Sha'ina Niris Yachad, you can't see these two beams next to each other, Lomar by Lovet, to say the rule of Lovet, Velekalamemer Bechitona Pia Yor Visosim, Dalesba Dalet. So that's why you can't say this halacha of Yorid Visosim. So a couple answers over here, basically in order to explain how in a scopa, how the door closing or opening makes a difference, you have to come up with one of these scenarios that involves specifically having beams on top of the threshold where the door can close and either cut it off from the Rishus HaYachid or the door is open and it's part of the Rishus HaYachid. Gemara now continues at the two dots. V'im haisa iskopa gavoa yud v'rchava dalid harezu rishus la'atzma. The halacha is that if a threshold is 10 tvachim high and 4 tvachim wide, it's its own rishus hayachid. So the question is, why is it its own rishus hayachid? Why can't it connect to the adjoining rishus hayachid? So Messiah leila Rav Yitzchak bar Avdimai. So this supports Rav Yitzchak bar Avdimai's principle. D'amar Rav Yitzchak bar Avdimai omer hayi Rav Meir. He quoted Rav Meir. Kol makom shata motze beiz rishuyos vehein rishus achas. Anytime you have two rishuyos, even if they're within one rishus, so you have two rishus hayachids within each other. Example, can go an amud b'rishus hayachid gavoy yod v'rachav dalet. The example would be, let's say I have a pillar in the middle of rishus hayachid. The pillar itself has the dimensions of rishus hayachid. It's 10 tvachim high and 4x4 tvachim wide. So in such a case, really, it should all be the same rishus hayachid. However, asur l'chasef olav, the halach is, you cannot put something Let's say take something off your shoulder and put it on that pillar. You're not allowed to do that. Gezeira misham tel brishas harabim, because it's a gezeira that maybe you're going to come to do that with the same exact scenario in rishas harabim. Now in rishas harabim, obviously you can't take something off your shoulder and put it on a pillar that's 4x4 tefachim wide and 10 tefachim high. You're literally transferring from rishas harabim to rishas hayachid. Because of that scenario, we say even in rishas hayachid you should not do this as well. That concludes daf tes amud aleph, and we will continue with daf tes amud beis in the next video.